Hello, I want to play a game.
In light of the Spyro movie coming out recently and having some pretty badass traps in that movie, I thought to myself, why not do a top 10 best soul traps in the entire series? And this is a very hard list to do because there's been so many traps, it was way harder than doing the worst to best in the entire franchise in terms of the movies. But the traps, there's been more good ones than more bad ones, to be honest with you. So it was a lot to pick from in, what, 9 movies now? So it was definitely a thing that took a lot of time to work on, but now I have finally done it, my 10 favorite. And some will surprise you and some will not surprise you. Now, in terms of the order of the list, I feel like some of you might predict some of them and some of you be like, well, what the hell are you on about? But hey, this is the beauty of opinions. And let me know in the comments, what is your 10 favorite traps in the entire series? And 10 worst traps, if you can think of that many bad traps. Now, when it comes to this list, I am picking the traps that are memorable, the ones that stand out and the ones that made me, you know, go on the edge of my seat and say to myself, what the fuck am I watching, and making me gross out several times. There's been many instances in this series where I was like, ew. And these 10 traps are, definitely have an impact on me. Some for how smart and innovative they are, and some for how flat out gory they are. So without further ado, let's fucking do this, boys and girls. My 10 favorite soul traps in the entire series. Now, number 10 is the trap from the most recent Saw movie, Spiral, the train track trap with the tongue. That one bothered me. I didn't like that. He had to leap himself off the thing and lose his tongue because he was a liar, lied in the court, or get hit by a train. Now, I had Final Destination 3 vibes with the train coming, and this is just not a good trap to be in. Like, imagine this guy. Yes, he's a liar, but damn, this officer just gets caught, put in this trap, his tongue will go. You know what that means, if he doesn't have a tongue, it is not an ideal trap to be in. It's definitely a gross out ooh, and the close-up shots of the tongue in this trap, it was disgusting. And he was about to do it as well, but he was too late and the train hit him. And definitely a good opening to the movie as well. It definitely set the tone for the rest of the movie and made you feel, oh, I am definitely in a Saw movie. Number 9 is the water box cube trap in Saw 5. Now, say what you want about Saw 5. Is it a great movie? Is it the best in the series? No. All the traps pretty good in that movie? Hell yes. There's another trap from that movie that's on this list. And in this one, it's just a really smart, innovative kind of trap. You got this guy's head in this box, and the water comes in, and he's completely stuck. He can do whatever he wants, you know, he can move his arms, his legs, anything, but his head's trapped in this box, and there's water coming down. Now, what makes this trap even better is how the guy escapes the trap. A special agent stabs himself with a pen that was left in his pocket for some reason, and did a tracheotomy, and he was able to breathe through the pen, and that was a badass way for the main protagonist of that movie to escape this trap, because this trap, you know, if he didn't have that pen, he would have been toasted and drowning as well, and especially when you're free to do whatever you want here, it is not ideal. And yeah, it was a very innovative trap, and I really enjoyed it. And I just love the traps in Saw 5, even though Saw 5, the storyline didn't really hold up to the traps of the movie, but number 9 is the water box trap with Special Agent Strom escaping in a really badass way. And I was wrong. Another trap, there's 3 traps from Saw 5 that is on this list, and number 8 is the pendulum trap. I think his name is Seth Baxter, and this is like a flashback scene when Hoffman took revenge for the killing of his sister. He has to put his hands through this, crush his hands, and he will escape this fucking thing swinging, getting closer inch by inch, and he goes through the pain of crushing his hands, and he still gets sliced in pieces, or sliced in half rather, not, you know, and This is the most terrifying, because you can see it swinging, the noise it's making. How this scene was shot, by the way, in the opening of this movie was fantastic. It made me so uncomfortable. I was dreading it as it was getting closer. And he was still alive afterwards, too. Like, he, obviously he was dying, but he didn't die straight away. It was a horrible way to die. Imagine crushing your hands just to have that happen to you anyway. And definitely the one of the better traps in the series, because it had them. I was like, ooh, what the fuck? I don't like that shit. That's horrible. And the look of it as well, it didn't look like Saw 3D when you see all the blood's purple or fucking pink and it ruined. No, it looked realistic as well. Most of these traps and how the body is destroyed, most of these sequels, it looks realistic and it looks gnarly as hell. And the character's not a likable guy. I think he raped Mark Hoffman's sister and he killed her after. But you definitely, I wouldn't say felt for him, but you could imagine how you would feel in that situation. And once again, another great opening trap scene. And definitely the second best trap in that movie, in my opinion. Number 7 is the one from Saw 6. Now this one is because it's smart and it's a nice John Kramer's way of poking fun out of the, I think his name is William Easton, and how the system, the healthcare system works. And it's a shotgun carousel trap when he has to pick who has to die and who can live. And this must be, it's not for the gruesome aspect, it's pretty straightforward. You got a shotgun and it's a carousel, obviously, and one, he has to pick two to survive out of six, hence Saw 6. These workers have been working for him for such a long time, so they have a bond to him, they look up to him, and a lot is on his shoulders. And in a way, he has to judge these people how he judged all these people who he turned down to the healthcare system, including John Kramer himself. It's just done beautifully well. You have some of them pleading, you know, you have some of them saying, there was one funny part, I remember laughing my ass off in the reaction, when she says, My parents are sick, and this dude's like, what the fuck are you on about? Your parents hate you. I'm like, they show their true colors around each other. Because, you know, when you are at work, when you are working with everyone else, you have, sometimes you pull a facade, like you pretend to like someone, but in reality you don't. And these people, you know, I'm pregnant. One of them actually dies, even though they said I'm pregnant. She was probably lying, you never know. And then this guy, the best part of this trap is, he saves two of them before one is, like, there's one left who knows he's gonna die, and he's like, you motherfucker, your system sucks, and I want you to look at me when I'm dead, when I'm gonna die. And it's such a powerful moment, and definitely a trap that is less reliant on the gore and more reliant on the characters and the story, the overall story of the movie. And it was really, really badass. I always use the word badass when I describe something, so do a drinking game. Every time I say badass, you drink, you're gonna get fucking wasted. But yeah, that moment was powerful, and definitely, I don't know, have I got another Saw 6 trap? No, I haven't. So this is my favorite Saw 6 trap, and it's simple but very, very effective. Now number 6 is the trap from Saw 2, another opening trap, and that is the eye death mask thing. Taking your eye out to get a key that's inside it. And the look of it too, his eyes all fucked up, and if he doesn't, this mask is gonna fucking come together with nails inside, and you're toasted. Now, I do have a question, like, how I would escape it. Maybe put your, I know you're still gonna bleed out from it eventually, but would you like put your arms maybe in the way? I was thinking that, or put something in the way, I don't know. Like, maybe there's a way to escape it, but obviously in 60 seconds, and being in a very stressful situation, you're not gonna think the way you would think outside the situation where you're not stressed out like he was. So I can just imagine the situation he was in. It must be dreadful, because taking your eye out, like, you would have a cool eye patch, but still, he doesn't have the ability to do it. You know, he's too scared. Maybe he doesn't have the guts, and he just screams out, and he's like, no, 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 and he just dies. And once again, that trap set the tone for the rest of that movie. Saw 2 is one of my favorite movies in this series, and that trap was fucking brilliant. It's not my favorite trap in the movie. I think you probably guess which one it is. I think that movie was the answer to the reverse bear trap of the first movie. Does he hold up to the reverse bear trap? No, but it definitely has an impact. What would you guys do in that situation? Would you get this knife and just fucking do that to your eye just to get the key? I'm like, could you have the guts to do that? I'll tell you now, I wouldn't. I would just scream out like a pussy. And I think I said that in my reaction video. But yeah, number 6, death mask from Saw 2. Number 5 is the Star Wars trap from Saw 5. Number five, so five, see what I did there? And yes, I call it the Star Wars trap. I don't know why. I don't know what it's actually called, the wall trap. But the reason why that is trap is because, number one, it's what I wanted to see. Like, in most movies, you don't really see you've always seen, like especially in Star Wars, for example, where the walls are closing in and they get saved the last minute. You never really see it actually happen, and you do. And it's slow and methodical, and it's completely eerie and just gnarly, because you like the character as well. You like Strom. You want him to succeed, at least I did. And you have Hoffman lying there, fucking grinning his arse off, like, I got you, bitch. I'm like, you motherfucker. And I actually grow to like Hoffman in Saw 3D when he just fucks everyone up, because I'm like, you know what? My man. Because everyone annoys me in that movie except from Hoffman. Yeah, but I was like, God damn it, Strom. Like, why did you do this? And he's trying to push the walls back, and it's like, you know he's fucked, but he's still trying. It's kind of sad. And he's climbing it, trying to escape at the top, and his arm gets stuck. And like, fucking hell. I'm claustrophobic as well. So that's why maybe I'm a bit biased. Cause can you just imagine? Just imagine that. That freaks me out. It freaks me out, okay? I just imagine being in that situation. It would be horrible. Like, I'm saying that a lot in all these traps. Imagine being in that situation. But, you know, that it just shows you how good these traps are. The way he dies and seeing the aftermath in Saw 6... Ew. It doesn't help that I actually liked Strom. It was kind of bittersweet in a way, because I wanted to see how the trap was going to go, but I didn't want to happen to Strom. If it happened to Hoffman, I would have been very happy, but oh well. Number four is a trap from Saw 3. Definitely not the last trap from Saw 3 on this list. I'm sure you can predict what will be next or on the horizon. And this is the Angel Trap. It's called the Angel Trap. When I was researching every trap, and it's the one with that Kerry detective, who I actually liked as well. You didn't really get much of her, to be honest with you. And she was from the first movie as well, and they killed her off kind of maybe a bit prematurely. But once again, the reason why I picked this trap is because it looks visually stunning in terms of when it finally happens. She has to put her hand in this acid to get the key, and she does, and it's all for nothing. Amanda's made this unescapable. And Hoffman, I think. Hoffman was a part of this, I believe. Let me know in the comments. And then a rib cage or whatever it is just rips apart, and it's a great shot. I'm like, Jesus. And Saw 3 is definitely the most gruesome one out of the series, I think. You could disagree with me, but like, if you watch my reaction to that, which is very old, and I did it in my bedroom, and no lighting whatsoever. It's really bad in terms of the production quality. But anyway... I was grossed out. I was grossed out the most in that movie. And this was one of the ones as well. And I felt sorry for Kerry Tay, whoever her name is. Put her hand in that acid just for that to happen to her. And she sees Amanda as well, probably rubbing her nose into it before that great shot happens. So when it comes to... So yeah, number four is the Angel Trap, a.k.a. Kerry getting fucked over by Amanda and Hoffman because they're dicks. And number three is the iconic trap from Saw 2, the needle pit trap, which was Amanda's trap, or actually it was Xavier's trap, but no, he didn't have the balls to do it himself, and he pushed her in. Poor Amanda, and obviously she has a history of this too, and she had to face her demons in a way to get the key to get the antidote because of the deadly nerve agent in the household. And I don't like needles. Close-up needles, I don't like that shit. If you saw my Hannibal reaction recently, there was a scene where there was a needle, and I don't like that shit. It makes me very uneasy. And when they showed me all these shots of her with all these needles all over her arms, all over her body, and the eerie music too, and the close-ups, and the, like, I hated that scene with a passion. And, you know, I love that. I love the one part where she's like, fuck you. And she just starts, you know, trying to... And she finds it. And then this fucking guy gets it, right? And he drops it. And then he runs out of time. And he blames Amanda for it. I'm like, bitch, you fucking jump in there then, you dick. And he's like, no. And he's sort of screaming. And number two is another iconic trap from the series. From the first movie that has carried on all the way till... Was it Saw 3D, maybe? Saw or Jigsaw? The reverse bear trap. Now, why isn't this number one? I don't know. I like it, though. I like the trap. It's a very genius, gruesome, scary trap. Like, you know, Amanda, she was the first victim of this. I feel like the best part of when she's watching the video and Jigsaw shows an example of what could happen. And you see the fear in her eyes. She's like, oh, shit. And then the montage is all crazy. She's like, and then she pulls the timer and then she has to stab her boyfriend or whatever, go on the insides and get the key. And she narrowly escapes. She just about escapes. And this happened. Then I love the scene of Hoffman as Saw 6. This is where I started to like Hoffman quite a bit. He used the door and it's still open, but partially, and he escapes it. And then that great shot of him screaming and half his jaw comes off. Like, Jesus. If you didn't like Hoffman before, you liked Hoffman then, at least as a villain. And then you see it finally work in Saw 3D. But seeing that trap just open up and see her tongue fall out, I'm like, ooh, glorious. And I love that part when Hoffman sees the trap, sees the reverse bear trap, and was like, and the music comes on and he gets it and grins. Like, this is definitely one of the most iconic traps in the series. If you ask any Saw fan, this is definitely in their top three. And I'm a new Saw fan, so maybe my opinion will change. But this trap, when I watched it in Saw 3D, and even when I watched it in the first one, I was like, fuck that. Fuck that shit. But not number one, but number two. And number one, you should know this if you watch my reactions, is the rat trap. Where do I start with this, guys? Where can I even start with this? Can you just imagine getting your arms and legs, your limbs twisting and your head twist? That's all I have to say. Can you imagine that? And I love Saw 3 for the forgiveness storyline with Jeff, who wants to commit vengeance for what happened to his son, Dylan. That was so corny the way I did that then. And he's been planning to kill this dude for a while. And then he's faced with the opportunity to watch him die in the most horrible way possible. Getting his arms once, one at a time. First his legs, I think, then his arms. And they don't pull away from these shots, guys. They do close-ups of it snapping. And I have refused to watch that scene again. I have watched some of these again just to see if I still feel the same way. But I'm not watching that shit again, okay? Because that is gnarly. That is just, ooh. And you can see, like, the bone in the back of his, oh, far. The sound design when that trap happens is done so goddamn well. And you feel sorry for this guy because, number one, the guy didn't mean to kill his son. It was by accident. And you could tell he felt really bad about it. There's, like, a flashback of him crying, I think. And when that happens to him, oh, it was horrible. Just horrible. Can you imagine being in that situation? But this dude's got his head twisted 180. And that's number one. That's my favorite trap when it comes to the impact it had on me. Like, that is definitely the most memorable trap to me because it was so disgusting. And it made me cringe all the way through the scene. The scene was done so well for a variety of reasons. Because there's some of these traps, they were only good because of the trap itself. But the story mixed in well with the trap as well about Jeff and is he going to help him or not, and he does try to help him, but at the very last minute. And in terms of what else he could be on this list, I was thinking of putting the freezer trap on of the lady who didn't help Jeff when his son died. But when it comes to the impact it had on me, I don't think it stacked up to the top 10 I had, but it was close. Let me know in the comments, what do you guys think? What is your 10 favorite traps in the entire series? You guys, just enjoy this video. I know you guys have enjoyed my Saw reactions, and I thought I would just do a top 10 Saw traps. I thought of it in the moment, I thought it would be a good idea, and yeah. If you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys next time. I had 7,000 views on my latest Spiral video, which is crazy. You guys are so nuts, and I love you all for it. You guys are awesome. And I love the varied opinions you guys have in the comments. Like, you guys are so passionate about it, and it's great getting into the series now because it's, you know, I'm like a part of a community a little bit, and it's kind of touching. It's sweet. It really is. And if you guys enjoy this video and enjoy my channel, support me on Patreon if you want, where you can watch Flying for Ashes on my Patreon when it comes to movies and TV shows and what I do on this channel. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time and have a good day.